Tell us something about the early times. Where were you born?
In Kansas.
What town there?
Round Ridge.
What was the year?
In 1888.
1888.
November the 9th. And I growed up there till I went to school. And I went to school there till we moved up here. The last year, I remember that we had German school there yet, and I went 3 months, or 3 weeks, I believe, to the German school. I could really read German good, but I just about forgot it all now. Now we grew up, we lived there in the neighborhood of my uncles, which I chummed together with those children, Uncle Henry Kane and Uncle William Kane. And William Kane was a man, he raised a lot of pigeons. Well, he got me interested, and I started raising pigeons. I made me a pen, and I raised some children and some pigeons to sell, and I sold a few. And that went on till we, pretty soon, Dad, my father, and mother, they decided to moved to Oklahoma. So Dad went and bought a farm here a mile south of Goldfield.
How old were you when
I was 12 years old when I left Kansas. And we loaded a carload of implements and horses, a few horses and cattle. And my dad sent me along. Dad went along and he put me in the car with another man. We was to bum us a ride. So we bummed us a ride, and first thing I knowed, I looked out, and the conductor seen me, and he come up, and he said, come back in behind the car. So I went back there, and Dad had to pay my fare. But we landed here in Oklahoma, and then we unloaded here one night in Enid, and next morning we moved down here where we live now, a mile south of Oklahoma. Mm-hmm. And I was 12 years old when we got here. Well, this was all new to us. We lived a mile and a quarter from a store. I'd have to go down there many times and get some groceries to walk. And I had brothers older than I. They done most of the work. I done some. But after a while, they growed up and got married, and then I had to do the biggest part of the farming for years there. And I had a cousin stayed with me, he helped me, Raleigh Coombs. He was a little mentally ill, but he helped me, and we farmed till I got married. Well, I shouldn't have said that.
Yeah.
What I mean, when I growed up to manhood, first thing I knowed, I was looking around for somebody else to stay with me. Well, it happened that I didn't have too much trouble finding one. I found one, and we got married.
Did you learn to know Grandma in Kansas?
No.
You didn't live too far apart there.
No, but I didn't. I don't remember knowing her.
Well, Grandma, how? When were you married?
We were married.
But yes, don't you want to tell where you come from?
Oh. Well, we lived at a mine south of the Kansas. And then I was 8 years old, and then we. Dad went down to New Country and bought us a farm there, and he made us hitch up a covered wagon, and then we all moved down there. It was 2 weeks to go, and part time we walked. We had a lot of fun. We and my cousins had one roof and them and with grandpa's together with my dad's folks.
That was a long way from
Valeria
to Minco.
Yeah,
it was raining when the sun was out. And the train should have got there.
It was Minco, Oklahoma, where we 10 miles east, west of Minco, Oklahoma. And there they unloaded that covered wagon and set it on the ground. And it was in October and it was kind of cold. And it was raining every night. And sometimes we lay in water a little bit. And we didn't like that country too well at first. And Mother, she had to get on the cart and drive to the neighbors and bake us some bread so we had some to eat. And then they cooked us some sorghum and spread that on the bread, and we lived on that a long time. And and then we lived there 7 years, and then Dad saw that I was begging out with American boys, and he didn't like that. Well, he made a sale, and he moved down here to Ringwood, Oklahoma. And then I got to, I was 16 years old then. And then,
You never dating at 16 then already, too?
Yeah. Then we had my cousins were living around there, and we had a good time together for a while there. And then my Aunt Eva, she lived here in Goldfish, and she always begged me to come and stay with her. And Mom had this one girl, she thought I should be home with her. But she wouldn't give up, and so she found me a job at Joe's brother, Abe Burke. There I worked 3 weeks, and the first night I come there, he come there with his folks, and he looked at me, and I looked at him. He'd always watch me. If I didn't look at him, he'd look at me. And that's the first time I saw him, and in a few nights, well, he came over to see me. And that's how we started off. And I think we went together almost 3 years.
Yeah, that was a good example.
And
I think you have something else. You didn't get that out, she meant to see some other girls.
Well, I
didn't agree between you and the other girls. She went to see another girl first.
Yeah, but I didn't know about that.
That wasn't that.
And her name was Gina, too. And I guess she didn't like it too good, but he didn't pay attention to that. So we got to go together, and finally, I don't know, we started. That's where we wanted to get married. We talked it over that we wanted to get married.
It was always a long way to drive, 11 miles of horse.
He came on the top buggy, and the day I knew he was coming, I always looked north, and I saw him by the church there, the Ringwood Church, and I knew it was him. And then I always worried about going back that long. Christmas was cold, you know, and now he just about froze. And we thought it was too far to go back and forth like that, so we decided to get married, and I was almost 21.
What year was that?
That was
1913. It'll be 50 years now, and
well, and then we started out on
married, and I rented my brother's place in Mile South, and that's where we lived. We just had a little house there. It was a pretty skimpy starting, but we started in.
Our folks gave us a cow and a heifer and 50 chickens while I raised my chickens at home, and I took them along. And then they got us a cook stove, a four-hole cook stove, and we burned wood in it. And they had a box in the corner for a cabinet. And we had a nice cupboard, and we had a table, and we had a nice bed, and we enjoyed our life there. Yeah.
I got a team of horses from home. Good team of horses. We thought we was really getting started.
And I remember the chicken I butchered. I think it was a pound and a half chicken, and we both ate that for one meal.
And then you, where did you go from that farm?
Well, we lived there 2 years, didn't we?
Well, Bertie was about 2.5 years old when he moved off of that place. And then he moved to just a little ways down.
He moved just across the road east.
Yeah.
From there. And we lived there a year or two. And then we moved back on the home place.
And then his father was sick, and he wanted us to move up there. And he only lived how long after we moved there?
Six weeks.
Something like
that. And then from that time you lived on that place.
You lived on that place?
31 years. We raised all our family. Except Mercer was about 3 years older than Mercer.
We raised our whole family on that one place. They all got married on that place. And then we moved to town from there. Well, when we sold that, I bought one quarter and the other quarter was sold to another man. We moved to town in 1950. We lived here.
On the
50th
place. Mm-hmm. For 3 years.
And then from 1953 till 50. Now you've been in this home?
10 years.
Oh, yeah.
10 years.
We moved to town, rented a place, we lived in there 4 years.
3 years.
3 years. And then we built us a house. We've lived in that since 1953.
Well, maybe we should find out what the children are doing, what they're. We probably should start with. Naming the children and then telling something about each of them.
Well, Virgil got married first, and then he lived on Grandpa's place, too.
Yeah, he got married by church in Oklahoma, and then he moved to Grandpa's, my home place. And he lived there. I can't tell you exactly how long, but I've been living there 2 years, but I'm not quite sure.
He visited him there one time.
And he rented another place, but then he didn't stay there for a year, and then he moved out west to church. And he was on his own then. And then Opal got married the same year.
Yeah, just the week apart.
They've been living around here since that, and Mildred got married, and they've been living around here, and Ruby got married, she married an minister, Walter is here, and they've been having churches at different places, I don't know where.
Well, I think Temple was the first place.
Tampa, Iowa, and...
Colby,
Kansas. Ben Clinton now. And Elgin got married. Marie Regier, Ned Newton, and he went down there and he had an accident and got killed there when he was 26 years old.
And
that's
the wife with two babies.
And we had a girl by the name of Tilly. She had got
run
over by a car and she died. And she was 8 years old. And then Robert got married last, that was the youngest. And he lived on the place where we lived, but he sold last again and he moved to Eden.
So you've had a lot of experiences of joy and sorrow.
We've had good days and bad days. We had good days and sad days. But we got along very good. When we look back, we can say the Lord has been good to us.
Our parents celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary in 1963 on January the 29th. It's a privilege for us to celebrate this 50th anniversary with them. We as children and grandchildren appreciated their testimony on this tape. Mother died in February of 1965, and Dad died in July of 1978. We'll always remember our parents and for the spiritual insight that they had for each of their children and their grandchildren. And even as parents have only one thing to take along with them in heaven, and that is their children who are prepared. It's a privilege to tape this in their home in Goldtree, the same year that they celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary. I asked these questions, and they responded. Walter Regier, being the son-in-law, asked these questions in their home.